Hello friends, welcome to YouTube channel Electronics for You. In this video, I will explain maximum power transfer theorem for DC networks. So the topics which is to be covered are statement, then proof, then steps to be followed for problem solving, and the last one is applications of maximum power transfer theorem. So these are the topics to be covered. Let me explain that maximum power transfer theorem for DC and AC circuits are different. So previously I have made videos regarding maximum power transfer theorem for AC network, but this video is specially for the DC network and it is with proof. The statement for maximum power transfer theorem is that the maximum power is delivered from source to load when load resistance equals to source resistance. Friends, here the maximum power transfer, this is the statement for maximum power transfer theorem, and the equivalent circuit which is to be used for maximum power transfer theorem is this one. Here RS is the source resistance, RL is the load resistance, V is the voltage supply which is applied here, that is source, and the last one is the current flowing through this is I. Now let us see the proof regarding the maximum power transfer theorem. So here is the proof. First we have to calculate the current flowing through this network. So the current I is equals to, simply by using Ohm's law we can find it, that is V upon R. Now the total resistance is, as these two resistances are in series, the total resistance will be RS plus RL. So the current I is equals to V upon RS plus RL. Now further we have to find the power delivered to the RL. So power is equals to I square R, that is the formula for powers. Now P is equals to I square multiplied by RL, as we are calculating the power delivered to the load resistance. Now we have already calculated the value for I, it is nothing but V. So I will write, it is I square, so V square divided by RS plus RL whole square, RS plus RL whole square multiplied by RL. So this is the formula for power delivered to the load. Now to determine the value of RL for maximum power to be transferred to the load, what we have to do? We have to differentiate it with respect to RL. So differentiate power, that is dp upon drl, and equate it with zero to find the maximum power. Now this is our power, so we will differentiate this, and therefore it will be equals to dt. We'll just write the value here, that is V square multiplied by RL upon this value, that is RS plus RL square, and we are equating it with zero. Now what will be the output? We have to differentiate it with respect to RL. So this term and this term is to be considered, while V square will be the constant here. So it will become V square multiplied by. Now we have to use the formula for this, and by using that we'll get denominator square, denominator as it is, that is RS plus RL whole square multiplied by derivative of numerator, that is derivative of RL is we are differentiating with respect to RL, therefore it is 1 minus, now numerator as it is, numerator is RL multiplied by derivative of denominator. Derivative of denominator will be 2 times RS plus RL upon denominator square. Denominator square will be RS plus RL, as it is already square, its square will be raised to power 4, and we are equating it with respect with 0. Now what we have to do, we have to simplify this term. So just multiply it with 0, this denominator will become 0. Also this v square will be here on the right hand side, and it will also become 0, and therefore we will get the value like this. Now what we have to do, we have we'll send this term to the right hand side, and therefore we'll get rs plus rl whole square equals 2rl multiplied by rs plus rl. Now you can see here that this term and this term is same, only the difference is raised to the power. So this will become rs plus rl equals to twice rl. Now see here that this is twice rl and this is rl. If we send it to the right hand side, we will get rs, therefore rs is equals to 2 times rl minus rl, it will be rl. That is source resistance equals to load resistance, and it is the statement for maximum power transfer theorem, and hence proved. Now steps to be followed for the maximum power transfer theorem. Note here that we will have a any circuit like this. It may be a two terminal linear circuit which is having a load resistance in between terminal A and B. We have to convert it into equivalent maximum power transfer theorem circuit, which is which will just look like this. Here this is RTH, that is Thevenin's equivalent resistance. VTH is the Thevenin's equivalent voltage source, and here this RL, this is the load resistance, and it should be equals to this is source resistance. Now what the steps we have to follow, we have to calculate VTH and we have to calculate RTH. These are the two first main steps. So to calculate VTH, what we will do, we will remove the load resistance from terminal AB. Okay, so after removing this, definitely this portion will be open here, and therefore we will calculate the voltage VTH here, and therefore this voltage VTH is nothing but Thevenin's equivalent voltage source, which can be calculated. That will be our second step. Now third step is to remove all the voltage sources and current sources, or we can say that we will replace it with their internal resistances. So voltage source is actually short circuited and current source is open circuited, and therefore further we can measure the resistance between these two terminals, that is AB, and it is nothing but RTH, that is Thevenin's equivalent resistance. Definitely for maximum power transfer theorem, you should first know the Thevenin's theorem, and further this RTH is equals to RL, as this is the statement for the maximum power transfer theorem. So here this RTH is nothing but equals to RL for maximum power transfer theorem, and if you want to calculate the maximum power, you have to calculate the current, and current flowing through this circuit, that is IL, is equals to VTH divided by these two resistances, that is RTH plus RL. Now we know that RL and RTH are same resistances, so it may be 2RTH or 2 twice RL. So the formula for current is VTH upon twice RTH, or we can say that VTH upon twice RL. Further we have to calculate the power, and maximum power P max will be equals to I square RL. So IL square RL, put the values here, and this term and this term will get cancelled, and here RL is equals to RTH, so it is replaced here, and therefore final formula is equals to VTH square upon 4 RTH, or we can say that VTH square upon 4 RL, as load and source resistances are same in this case. So these are the steps to be followed. Further, the applications for the maximum power transfer theorem, especially it is used in electronics. So friends, the first application for the maximum power transfer theorem it is used in radio communication, where the source resistance is to be matched with the load resistance. Generally, in case of radio communication, source resistance is nothing but transmitter's resistance, or instead of resistance we will say impedance. So transmitter's impedance and antenna's impedance should be matched. This is the at that time we have to use the maximum power transfer theorem, and we can say that it is the concept specially known as impedance matching. Further, we can use our maximum power transfer theorem in case of audio system, where the impedance of amplifier and the impedance of speaker should be matched. And again, for that maximum power will be delivered to the speaker, and further definitely maximum sound will be here. And therefore, this is the second application for maximum power transfer theorem. In next video, I will we'll talk about the problems for the maximum power transfer theorem, you can watch here, or you can see the link in description. Thank you. And friends, if you like this video, please subscribe our channel and press the bell icon for notification, and like, comment and share. Thank you.